Thank you, Chairs. Commissioner, good morning.
Good morning, Senator.
I have a couple of questions to ask you. Number one, you talked about this extensive affordable housing plan that the governor is rolling out, but no one's talked or heard anything about the MWBE component and how that is going to roll out and what guarantees that you can have to ensure that those folks that are interested in being developers can have an opportunity to be part of the program. Can you illuminate any of that program, or has any of that been worked out as yet?
Senator, I'm delighted that you asked that. MWBE, as you know, the governor's commitment to MWBE goals is a core of his agenda and has been since day one of his first term. He recently raised the statewide goals from 20% to 30%, as I know you're also aware. Our agency in the most recent year, when the goal was 20%, exceeded that 20% goal, and with a new 30%, of course, it's our full intention to hit or exceed the 30% goal with our new programs and our existing programs. I guess the one other thing that I would add is I am particularly lucky that Bill Thompson, the former controller of the city, former head of the Board of Education, et cetera, who was, I think, the chairman of the governor's task force on MWBE, is now the chairman of one of my agencies, the Housing Finance Agency. And so the chairman and I have spent a tremendous amount of time since the day I walked in the door talking about our efforts at the agency to meet and exceed all the MWBE goals that the governor set for us.
I have a follow-up question on the Housing Finance Agency. I'm told there's a backlog in putting in applications, and there's a difficulty with developers in trying to get meetings to apply for Housing Finance Agency credits. Can you tell us, is that unit fully staffed, and if there is a backlog, what that backlog consists of?
Senator, I'm not aware of any unusual backlog. Our staff, we have an extraordinarily committed and dedicated staff at the Housing Finance Agency, at HFA, as throughout the rest of our agency. They are in constant contact with the development community, and they move through projects at a rapid pace on a cycle that's very predictable.
Is it a monthly cycle?
I'm sorry, sir?
Do they see people on a monthly cycle? I'm told it's only a quarterly cycle that they allow new applications to come in.
We have regular capital availability cycles. For some of our programs, we have regular capital availability cycles, and then for some, we have what's called an open resolution, where there's sort of an ongoing dialogue about projects. It seems to work well, and since I've been here, just judging from the pace of projects that come in the door and then go out the door after award, I would say it moves quickly and efficiently.
Okay. I represent, my Senate district represents a lot of Mitchell-Lamer and properties now, and I'm having some questions regarding issues on the HCR and the timing of reply to requests on complaints regarding everything that from the ability to track whether or not a building is still getting the rent control. I have an issue with many nonprofits that are moving in, people that have mental illness and difficulty, mental capacities into rent-stabilized apartment complexes, creating angst for the long-term renters that have been there, and also taking those apartments out of rent control. Mm-hmm. Can you tell us what the staffing ratio is to address those complaints that are coming in?
Well, it sounds like, Senator, it sounds like, first of all, you have some specific complaints relating to specific buildings in your district.
Yes.
And I think the best way to proceed there is either the tenants, if there are tenant complaints, we have a very active inbound process for tenants to call in with complaints. If there are specific issues, I would encourage your staff, and I'll make sure that my staff follows up with yours to make sure that we have a good roster of what the specific issues are.
Well, I'd like to do a meeting with your staff regarding two complexes in my district, Hollis Court Apartments in Cunningham Heights, where there's a preponderance of this problem where they're having a lot of nonprofits bringing in mentally ill people that are having problems. Can you tell us what the normal turnaround time for our MC, major capital improvement, is, and if your staffing is adequate to respond to those requests from people that are trying to get credit or acknowledge, even acknowledging whether MCI is done? Because I'm getting a lot of complaints also from both sides, the tenants and the developers and landlords, that MCIs are not recorded or not even recognized.
Senator, we have talked a couple times. I mentioned a couple times earlier that we are fully aware that what is a very, very complicated process within the Office of Rent Administration can take a fair amount of time. It can be, like other things that happen in government, frustrating to both sides of the issue. Part of the reason for that, frankly, is that there is a requirement that we provide full due process to everybody who's involved. And I think that if, you know, as anybody who is on either one of those, if you, you know, either seat that you're sitting in, you would want the ability to have full due process, and due process takes time. In the end, we think that the ORA folks, who are extraordinarily dedicated, come to the right answer, they put out the right, they get the right result, and if an MCI, to take one example, is fully justified at whatever level it was put in or at some reduced level, it's implemented in a way that makes it possible for that building, that specific building, to be financially feasible and at the same time provide housing on a rent-stabilized basis and probably affordable to the people that live there.
Well, I hope that we can get some more staff to ramp up the timing and also some more investigators to come out and look at the issues as well.
Thank you,
We've
Senator.
Put in some requests and we haven't gotten responses back, so I would appreciate the opportunity to get more details. And if you could send me the details on the MWBE and how people apply and what this ratio is of developers that are applying, because I'm getting, again, back to the first question, a lot of developers are saying they haven't had an opportunity to even hear back from HFA regarding their request for state matching funds. Thank you.
Will do. Thank you, Senator.